So peace orders in South Africa, which is also most commonly known as a protection order. This is a legal document that specifies the conditions that the wrongdoer must adhere to as specified by the court. Now, this legal document can specify, for example, that the wrongdoer should not commit any act of domestic abuse, or that he should pay rent, mortgage, or other money such as child support or spousal maintenance, or that he should hand over any firearm or dangerous weapon to the police. Now, prior to obtaining a protection order, you need to apply for an interim order. Now, an interim order then specifies the date at which a final order will be considered by the courts. Now, once the final order is made, it will be permanent and can only be changed by then applying to court again. So any court that covers the area in which you live or work, or in which the wrongdoer lives or works, or the area in which the incidents of abuse took place, can grant a protection order. So now I am going to discuss the process of obtaining a protection order. The application for a protection order is ex parte, which means that it is brought by the complainant by you without notice given to the respondent. Now, in addition to the application, the application can be brought on behalf of the complainant by any person who has a material interest in the well-being of the complainant. The application is on affidavit and therefore needs to be certified by making an oath in front of a commission of oaths stating that you know and understand everything that you have written down. And the prescribed forms can be found at police stations and courts or downloaded from the Justice and Constitutional Development website. The form must be then completed in full by the complainant or alternatively by the clerk of the court, or an attorney can assist the complainant. The magistrates will then consider the application, and if the magistrate is satisfied that there is prima facie, which means accepted on the face of it, evidence that the requirements set out that I will discuss next have been met, and then he must issue an interim protection order. The interim order, as well as a copy of the application and a record of any additional evidence which was considered by the court, must be fully served or delivered on the respondent by a police officer or a sheriff in order to have effect. Serving the interim order by the police is free. However, if you can afford the service charges of a sheriff, this will be more effective, as the police may have many cases and are likely to take longer than the sheriff. Once the clerk receives the return of service in respect of the interim order, confirming that it has been delivered or served on the respondent in the prescribed manner, a warrant of arrest which authorizes the arrest of the respondent must be served on or given to the complainant. The warrant's execution is suspended and is subject to the respondent complying with any prohibition, condition, obligation, or order imposed by the court. Should the respondent contravene the terms of the interim order or a final protection order, the complainants may hand in the warrant of arrest together with an affidavit dealing with the incidents relating to the respondent's non-compliance to a member of the South African Police Service. The South African Police Service then has the option to either arrest the respondent if it appears that the complainants may suffer imminent harm as a result of the breach, or deliver in person a written notice to the respondent calling on the respondent to appear before court on a specified date on a charge of contravening the terms of the interim order. This charge will be dealt with as a criminal matter separately from the civil proceedings of the protection order. The interim order only remains valid until the return date, which is typically about 3 months from the date of having the interim order issued, on which date the respondent must show cause and establish why a final protection order should not be granted. So the final protection order will be granted if the wrongdoer does not oppose the interim order, or if the wrongdoer is not present at court but there is proof that the interim order was served on the wrongdoer, or if neither party is present but there is proof that the interim order was served, then the final protection order will be granted. If the wrongdoer is present and contests the granting of a final protection order, the case will go to trial. The magistrates will hear all the evidence given by yourself, the complainant, or any witnesses, and make a decision. Once a final order is granted, a warrant of arrest is issued immediately, but is suspended as long as the wrongdoer does not break the conditions of the protection order. So now I'm going to take you guys through the process or the steps of completing the form, or the prescribed form, which can also be found on our website www.lawyers.easyfind.co.za, which will be at the bottom of the screen as well. So firstly, the applicant section. This requires the information of the complainant. However, if you are applying on the complainant's behalf, you will need to fill out the details, which includes your ID number, home and work address, employment details, and your relationship to the wrongdoer. So, your ID number, your home, work address, employment details, like I've said, sorry, your relationship to the victim, the reason you are making this application, and whether you have permission from the victim or not. Second part is the respondent's details, which includes their ID number, their home and work address, telephone numbers, and job details should be provided. Residential and work addresses are important for effective service or deliver of the order. If you do not know the addresses, then you should give any information about where the respondent can be found, such as public places or friends they often visit. Then the third part is others who are affected, details of anyone else affected and how they are affected should be described. You need to give a statement of the incident, which is an affidavit detailing the incident by the wrongdoer, and any information on how urgent the application is. For example, the reason to fear that the respondent may act violently, what conditions you need in the protection order. These conditions should match up with the type of abuse you have noted. And any personal property should then be listed that you consider personal. If you have asked for assistance from the police in collecting your personal property, they will require this list. Now that is the process of a protection order, and if you are going through any types of abuse, or your partner is not paying any maintenance, or your life is in danger, you can always apply for a protection order by going to court, your nearest court, and going to the domestic violence section and applying for a protection order, an interim protection order, and then a final interim, and then a final protection order will be granted. If you found this video informative, then please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, click on the bell button for post notifications, and stay tuned for the next video.